James Margolin, a spokesman for U.S. prosecutors in Manhattan, declined to comment on whether Zarab was cooperating with the authorities. A lawyer for Zarab, Benjamin Braffman, declined to comment for this article. Zarab and eight other people, including Turkey's former economy minister and three executives of Turkish state-owned Halk Bank, have been charged with engaging in transactions worth hundreds of millions of dollars for Iran's government and Iranian entities from 2010 to 2015 in a scheme to evade U.S. sanctions. Only Zarab and Mehmet Hakan Atilla, one of the Halk Bank executives, have been arrested by U.S. authorities. Ex-minister Zafer Kaglian, who has not been arrested by the United States and remains in Turkey, is also accused of receiving tens of millions of dollars in bribes from the proceeds of the scheme. The Turkish government has said he acted within Turkish and international law. Kaglian, Zarab, and Atilla have denied all the charges against them. Victor Rocco, a lawyer for Atilla, declined to comment on the case. Kaglian could not be reached for comment. Halk Bank says all its transactions fully comply with Turkish and international regulations. Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan's government has said the case has been fabricated for political motives. The tensions it has exacerbated between Ankara and Washington, NATO allies, have hit investor sentiment toward Turkey, and traders say it has also contributed to the lira's fall to record lows. U.S. prosecutors claim that the defendants helped Zarab use his network of companies to supply currency and gold to the Iranian government and Iranian entities, violating U.S. sanctions. Turkish Prime Minister Binali Yildirim said the charges were baseless, and that Turkey had not violated its own or international laws regarding exports and trade. Plot against Turkey. The Zarab case is a clear plot against Turkey, a political case and lacking any legal basis, government spokesman Bekir Bozdag said last week. The defendants in the case are under pressure and being forced to make statements against our country, Yildirim said, without explanation. The case is acutely sensitive in Turkey because the prosecutors say a Turkish government minister, Kaglian, was involved in the alleged conspiracy to evade the U.S. sanctions. Erdogan has not been accused of any wrongdoing, but has repeatedly expressed frustration with the case. Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlut Cavusoglu has said he sees in this case the hand of Muslim cleric Fethullah Gulen. Erdogan accuses Gulen of masterminding last year's failed military coup in Turkey and also of driving an earlier legal case involving Zarab. In that earlier case, Turkish prosecutors accused Zarab and high-ranking Turkish officials of involvement in facilitating Iranian money transfers via gold smuggling. After details of the Turkish prosecution were leaked in 2013, several prosecutors were removed from the case and police investigators were reassigned. Erdogan branded the case an attempt by Gulen's supporters to undermine his government and the investigation was later dropped. Cavusoglu said the two legal cases were exactly the same, and showed the extent to which Gulen had infiltrated American state institutions, including its judiciary. Needless to say, those claims are ridiculous, acting U.S. Attorney Jun Kim said last week. The case has been handled by career prosecutors concerned only with U.S. law, not Turkish politics, Kim said, adding, they're not Gulenists. Gulen denies involvement in the failed 2016 coup or any other attempts to undermine Erdogan and his government. Economic hit. The Zarab case is one of several festering disputes between Ankara and Washington, which disagree over U.S. support for Kurdish fighters in Syria and suspended visa services after the arrest of a locally employed U.S. consulate worker in Istanbul last month. In a speech on Wednesday, Yildirim highlighted the economic fallout from the court hearings, saying they had come to the point of harming Turkey and our global economic ties. Investors are nervous. Turkish bank shares have fallen more than 13% in November, nearly twice the decline of the broader Istanbul market. Jury selection is due to start on Monday, meaning the trial may begin as early as Tuesday.